Undercover video from an employee at an Amazon facility, apparently in Scotland, shows that millions of unsold products get destroyed, including incredibly valuable products as well. Let's show you a little bit of this video that one of the workers gave to ITV in Britain.
Secret footage captured in what's known as the destruction zone, and that calls into question the company's environmental and ethical practices. An ITV News investigation reveals unsold laptops scanned not for delivery, but instead marked destroyed. Boxes full of electrical items, such as drills, shavers, headphones, even smart TVs. The list goes on. Brand new books still in their wrappers, or jewelry or steel cutlery with that same instruction, destroy.
And look, I think even if that was just a little bit of that, that would be pretty insane. But apparently there's a weekly target at that one facility of 130,000 items to destroy. And apparently, like, so there's different ways you can get rid of these things. You can destroy it or you can give it away. I think many of you watching that are probably thinking, wait, can't you just give that to people? Like random people, or I don't know, maybe just the employees who you're abusing. Well, they do give away a little bit. In comparison to the 124,000 items marked destroy, 28,000 were marked donate. So isn't that nice? A tiny little percentage of it. And, you know, it's some stuff, it's like, you know, cheap jewelry or whatever, but it's MacBooks and it's fans and iPads and TVs, and this whole thing just seems insane, Yasmin. I don't understand what system could produce the need for this much destruction and waste.
It's like the ERCOT thing that we were talking about earlier, how, you know, I'm being expected to recycle and conserve as much as possible, but you have people like Amazon, well, I guess not people, but you have companies like Amazon who are just being so wasteful and they're seeing no consequences of it. And there's a reason why Jeff Bezos is going to space and there's a petition to leave him there, you know, because he's doing so much harm to this country, so much harm that so many people around the entire globe are trying to combat. But how can you possibly compete with it? It's so wasteful. Any kind of waste kind of hurts my heart. I don't like it. I don't know if that's because I was just the way I was raised or whatever the case is, but any kind of waste is waste. You know, it doesn't need to happen and it's so pointless. And I am curious as to what determines whether something is destroyed or donated. Like what is the criteria there? And why is one so much more than the other and not the other way around?
I don't know. I am hoping that enough, if enough people talk about this story, that maybe they will shed a little bit of light on that. Preferably, maybe change the situation a little bit. But it's pretty bad. Like 6 million products at that facility. A previous report in France found 3 million products being destroyed. So that's France and Scotland. I will just assume that nothing like this happens in the United States. But if it does, that could be really bad. And so this is just one of a number of different issues that thankfully employees at Amazon have made people aware of. This is a massive corporation. There are some benefits to that, but there are clearly a lot of negatives, both in terms of the ethical implications of wrecking TVs and stuff rather than giving them away, but also the environmental stuff. 6 million products for one facility, that's a lot of waste that's being produced. Maybe there could be practices that would make it not actually have to happen at all. But anyway, maybe at some point we'll learn more. Thank you to all the reporters that are talking with employees and getting us this information.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.